you got a real choice in Omaha come 2 weeks from tomorrow. You can either move forward or you can move backwards. You can either make sure the taxpayers, the hard-working taxpayers, continue to be in charge in this city, or you can go backwards and put the big government special interest back in charge. You don't want that. I think the choice is pretty clear. You want to go forward, right? Some people ask, why am I here? I said, it's real simple. It wasn't just because Pete's a good friend and he asked to come on by. It wasn't just because I had met and heard of your governor or your mayor before and knew the good work that Gene had done. But I looked at the contrast and I heard that you had another visitor last week. You know, it's interesting contrast. I said the difference between an East Coast radical, a socialist, and that's not calling names, that's what he calls himself, an East Coast socialist who came into town, or just a fellow Midwesterner who believes in common sense. That's why I'm here. You see, they've got a national agenda. That's why they're in, that's why they're elsewhere. We're here in the Midwest because we believe in common sense. We believe in putting the taxpayers in charge, not the big government special interest. And I got to tell you, with your mayor, you've got one hell of an advocate for the hard-working taxpayers of Omaha. Think about all the good things that your mayor, Mayor Gene Stafford, has done over the last few years. This is a city, Omaha is a city that's working again. Over 12,000 new jobs, employment's up, population's up. This is one of the most dynamic cities of its size in the country. It's a great place to find a job. It's one of the best places to work for a small business. It's a great place for college students and millennials and young entrepreneurs. You want that to continue going forward, don't you? And not only is the city working, but Omaha is safer. It's safer because of Mayor Gene Stafford. Think about this. She's not only added more police to be out and beat patrolling this city, she's actually added a fifth, along with the council, a fifth police district. And because of that, you now have homicide rates that are the lowest in more than a decade, and shooting rates that are lower than they've been in more than a dozen years. Do you want to continue doing that going forward? But not only is Omaha working and is Omaha safer, but because of your mayor, Omaha is fiscally sound again and putting the taxpayers back in charge. Think about that. As Pete mentioned, not once but twice, working with the Common Council, she's lowered, not just frozen, lowered the property tax rate in this city. She has balanced the budget. And she's put together and negotiated contracts with every one of the bargaining units here that put the taxpayers back in charge. And I got to tell you, that's why there's protesters outside, because they don't like it when a mayor stands up for the hardworking taxpayers. They want to be in charge again. You're not going to let them. You see, that's the contrast. That's really what's at stake. That's what we went through a few years ago. Your great governor alluded to that. You know, we had the first successful recall in American history. First time a governor's ever faced a recall and successfully did. We won not once, not twice, but three times. And I'm proud to tell you, despite what the signs say, in our state, not only did we win in a state that was once so blue, we hadn't gone Republican for president since 1984, we were elected three times. We changed the focus. We now have more people employed in the state of Wisconsin than ever before. Last year, wages in the private sector were up 7.5%. We're in the top 10. Just like Nebraska, we're in the top 10 of the best states when it comes to the percentage of people in the workforce. We've got high graduation rates and high ACT rates. We've got all the right things happening because why? We put the taxpayers back in charge, and that's exactly what you need to do and continue to do here in the city of Omaha. Put the taxpayers back in charge. Now, Now, Gene's opponent brought in Bernie Sanders last week. Now, that should tell you a lot, because like I said, he doesn't just come in for anybody. I mean, he doesn't just come in for liberals. You've got to be a liberal's liberal to get Bernie Sanders to come in and campaign for you. I mean, he is a socialist, and sometimes people call people that and they get offended. Bernie Sanders wears that as a badge of honor. He is a proudly proclaimed socialist. In the Midwest, I don't think we want East Coast socialists telling us what to do. But apparently, your candidate, your mayor's opponent, thinks that's just fine. Because not only has he had a track record, as the governor alluded to, of voting against tax cuts, of voting for tax increases, of advocating for more government spending, but now on an issue that should be fundamental, no matter what side you stand on, he went from a guy who once proclaimed to be pro-life to, now I can't quite figure out what he is, other than somebody told him in Bernie Sanders' team, you can't be pro-life if you want to have his support. If that's the public change he's made, if that's the public flip-flop, imagine the promises he's made to the people outside you won't find out about until after the election, when you'll start paying more for it. Those aren't Midwestern values. Midwesterners, we look you right in the eye and we tell you what you're doing. That's why you need a mayor like the mayor you have now. You need to continue to have that mayor. You need a mayor who's not going to be intimidated, who's not going to back down, who's going to do day in and day out, no matter what the pressure, no matter what the pushback, no matter what the attention, no matter what the protest, who's going to do what's right for the hardworking taxpayers of this city. And ladies and gentlemen, that's the kind of mayor you have. And come a week, 2 weeks from tomorrow, 2 weeks from tomorrow, I pray for this city, for this state, and for this country, you, not the people in Washington, not the people on the East Coast, but the people of Omaha send a strong message that we don't want the big government special interests in our city, our state, or for that matter, anywhere across our country. We want advocates to put the hardworking taxpayers once and for all in charge and keep them in charge. And that's what you get from your current and future mayor, Gene Stauffer. Let's bring it up.